In 1969, a time when restrictions were placed on students' rights in school, the Tinker and Eckhart families broke through the barrier by defying their school's restrictions on student speech.
The significance of Tinker versus Des Moines is that it was the first court case that provided protection for the rights of students in school.
The Vietnam War was a war against communism in Vietnam, pitting North Vietnam and South Vietnam against each other. South Vietnam's closest ally at this time was the United States.
Throughout this war, many protests were held all over the country to oppose our involvement in it.
One reason for these protests were the mistreatment of prisoners of war in Vietnam.
These prisoners were abused mentally and physically daily. They were even brainwashed into believing they had committed war crimes.
Another reason for the protests were the deaths of Americans in Vietnam.
Many people believed that America had no place in the war. They also believed that the deaths of American soldiers could have been avoided if this war never began.
They didn't see a point for the fighting, so they thought the deaths of American soldiers were in vain.
Many smaller protests and marches were taking place all over the country, culminating in the March Against the Vietnam War in Washington, D.C.
The first of many in Washington, D.C., this march was organized by Students for a Democratic Society and took place on April 17, 1965.
In later months, the Tinkers would attend one of the demonstrations in Washington, showing their support of the recently announced truce plan.
The truce would halt the war for 24 hours beginning on Christmas Eve. This plan gained support and criticism from people all over the country.
On December 11, 1965, a meeting was held which the Tinkers attended in the Eckhart House. At this meeting, it was determined that anyone who was, quote, interested in expressing their grief over the deaths of soldiers and civilians in Vietnam, end quote, would fast and wear black armbands on December 16th. The idea to wear armbands came from Herbert Hoover, a distant cousin of President Herbert Hoover, one of the men who helped plan the trip to the first anti-Vietnam War protests in Washington, D.C. The influence for this idea was the black armbands that soldiers and families of fallen soldiers used to wear to mourn the dead. During this meeting, posters were created and put up around town.
After hearing the news of a planned protest, school district principals met and enacted a rule stating that no one would be allowed to wear the black armbands to school.
The school's reasoning behind banning this protest was that they believed it would cause unnecessary issues and disrupt the learning environment, which would make the protest a violation of, quote, general school policy, end quote. This rule was announced to students on December 15th.
After the school announced the rules surrounding the wearing of black armbands, the Tinkers had second thoughts about participating in the protest.
However, deciding to disobey the school district, the Tinkers wore the armbands to school to express their beliefs about the ongoing situation. Their strong beliefs against the war, as well as beliefs about student expression, overpowered the possible repercussions. Mary Beth Tinker stated that, quote, "Sometimes you might get in trouble for peaceful protests, but that sometimes you should still do that," end quote.
Following their participation in the protest, Mary Beth Tinker and Christopher Eckhart were suspended and John Tinker was sent home. However, Hope and Paul Tinker were not suspended and were instead allowed to participate in a discussion about the war and their rights in school.
News of the suspensions were spread around the town and school. Some citizens in Des Moines agreed with the Tinkers' protest, but most supported the school system in their decision. Some people even decided to write letters to the Tinkers criticizing their decision to protest. One letter said, quote, "Nobody's right of free speech is being denied, except yours for a better influence on your children," end quote.
The students who had been suspended would not be allowed back to school until they were willing to remove the armband. None of the students who were suspended agreed to these terms.
Outraged at what they thought was a violation of rights, the Iowa Civil Liberties Union approached the Tinker family to discuss a lawsuit. On March 14, 1966, a lawsuit was filed against the Des Moines Independent School District. The court date was set for June 25, 1966.
From June 25th to 26th, Mary Beth Tinker, John Tinker, Christopher Eckhart, and school officials testified in the U.S. District Court. On September 1st, 1966, the U.S. District Court announced their decision, favoring the school district, ruling that the school was not in violation of the Tinker and Eckhart children's rights.
After the outcome of the U.S. District Court case was announced, an appeal was sent to the U.S. Eighth Circuit Court on September 28, 1966. The vote ended in a tie on November 3, 1967, providing another win for the school.
The loss in the Eighth Circuit Court of Appeals forced the Tinkers to appeal the case to the U.S. Supreme Court, and on March 4, 1968, the Supreme Court agreed to hear the Tinkers.
Beginning on November 12, 1968, the Supreme Court heard oral arguments from Dan Johnson, speaking for the Tinkers and Eckharts, and Alan Herrick, representing the involved school officials. During the time that the Supreme Court justices were deliberating, the Tinker family received hate mail and death threats.
On February 24, 1969, the court reached a final decision. In a vote of 7-2, they decided that the Des Moines Independent Community School District was in violation of Mary Beth Tinker, John Tinker, and Christopher Eckhart's First Amendment rights.
Supreme Court Justice A. Fortas wrote the majority opinion stating that the school's decision was, quote, based upon an urgent wish to avoid the controversy which might result from the expression. Even by the silent symbol of armbands, the opposition to this nation's part in the conflagration in Vietnam, end quote.
The court's decision was made law concerning both children and adults equal in terms of the First Amendment. This implication was later rewritten in Bethel School District versus Frazier and Hazelwood versus Kohlmeier by limiting rights granted to students.
Although the majority was in favor of the students, two Supreme Court justices, Hugo Black and John M. Harlan II, dissented.
Hugo Black believed that symbolic speech is not protected under the First Amendment. He stated that, quote, I have never believed that any person has the right to give speeches or engage in demonstrations where he pleases and when he pleases, end quote.
John M. Harlan II found that, quote, nothing in this record which impugns the good faith of respondents in promulgating the armband regulation, end quote.
Immediately after the ruling decision of the case was announced, newspaper articles were written and published around the country.
Although they had won the court case, many community members in Des Moines still held the same opinion as before. However, the statement from the Supreme Court was finalized.
All over the country today, students have continued to protest and stand up for what they believe in or oppose.
Students now have the ability to comfortably exercise their First Amendment rights due to Tinker vs. Des Moines.
More recently, students have used their rights to protest gun violence.
Walkouts, rallies, and marches have been organized and executed by students all around the country.
Mary Beth Tinker has also continued to spread her story to children and adults all over the country.
She created Tinker Tour, which has allowed her to travel from school to school teaching kids about Tinker versus Des Moines, as well as the Constitution.
However, 19 years after the ruling of Tinker versus Des Moines, the Supreme Court limited the rights of students. The Supreme Court ruled in Hazelwood versus Kohlmeier that student newspapers are subject to lower level protection by the First Amendment.
Now the Tinker test, or substantial disruption test, is used to decide whether a school's decision infringes upon students' First Amendment rights.
Today, in our school, we have opportunities to use our voice through the school newspaper and student council. Students are able to write and publish opinion, news, events, sports, and review articles. This opportunity is not only available at our school, but at schools all over the country.
The Tinker and Eckhart families broke through the barrier by defying their school's restrictions on student speech.
The court's decision, although it was reversed in later years on other cases, has affected students all over the country, even for years after the final decision.
This topic has, and will continue to, influence students to use and explore their First Amendment rights.